We have here the winners of the Google Science Fair, who we'd like to have a little bit of a discussion with. So you want to come up onto stage here, Brittany, Sakhiwe, Bonkhe. Have a seat. Okay, so what I'd like to do to start off with is let's run the first video.
I am Sakhiwe and I am 14 years old. Being born and raised in Swaziland, I've experienced some of the many challenges that our country is facing. Many families in Swaziland rely on food aid.
I am Bonkhe, I'm also 14 years old and go to school with Sakhiwe. My father is a farmer. Because of drought and soil erosion, he does not produce enough food each year. I believe young people enjoy asking questions to solve problems, and that's why I love science so much. Hydroponic farming is a method of growing produce without soil, but for poor farmers it is too expensive. We developed a unique simplified hydroponics method to grow vegetables using a nutrient solution made from mature chicken manure. We grew vegetables to test if these or traditional methods produced better results. Our system increased the amount produced by 140%. By empowering farmers with knowledge of simplified hydroponics, Swaziland can be a better place to live.
I see the Google Science Fair as a step to prove to the community that even someone as young as me can make a difference.
I believe in myself today and know my time is now, not sometime tomorrow when I am old.
Winning the science fair as young Swazi scientists cannot change the world, but can change the way we live in it.
So Sakhiwe and Bonkhe, this is it's a very overwhelming experience, I think, for you to be here. But really, the ones who should be overwhelmed are all of us. The Google Science Fair, thousands of science fair entries from over 100 countries, and these guys finished first. So how about that? So I think that I think the audience would be very interested in hearing about the creative process here. You're at home, you're hanging out. Where did you get the idea that you should do something like this?
Well, Sakhiwe and I both know that Swaziland is facing a number of challenges, including a lack of soil fertility, which used to fuel our yields. So we searched of ways of farming, and we came across the hydroponics method, but we also found that it is expensive and it needs someone to experience. So we tried ways of simplifying it, and that's how we came that's why we created the unique simplified hydroponics method.
Okay, so you found a method that worked. How much of this was doing background research versus trial and error? Both ways are legitimate ways to do science.
We found out about the project, about the hydroponics method. And then we thought, before we proceed with experimenting, it's better if we have a lot of research in case it fails. So
a great deal of background work went into it.
Yes.
How long did it take you to get something that worked from the time that you started the research?
We did the research for about 3 weeks. Then after that, we started proceeding with the project, and it went very well.
So one of the, you're trying to address what is really an outstanding question, which is availability of food,
yes.
which is a great challenge to humanity. Another great challenge in the area that you live in is the available of clean water, okay?
Yes, yes.
And have you thought about whether or not there's enough water available to take this idea and really scale it up to the point where it can be useful?
As you may know, that wood absorbs moisture. So as we use sawdust, it holds the water. So when the plant is planted, it uses the water from the sawdust.
So it's very efficient in terms of water usage.
Yes.
Well, I think all of us would like to encourage the two of you to really continue this project, which I think has great, great promise for your area and beyond. So thank you very much.
Thank you.
Okay, and now if we could run the second video, please.
I want to be on the frontier trying to find the cures to different types of cancer and trying to make cancer as treatable as something like influenza. And I would love to be able to be on a team that's having that kind of impact. My project is entitled Global Neural Network Cloud Service for Breast Cancer. Basically, I taught the computer how to diagnose breast cancer so that it can determine whether breast masses are malignant or benign. I programmed the computer to mimic the way the brain thinks and model the interconnections so that it can detect patterns and diagnose based on these biopsies that aren't as invasive. The next step for my project is to get more data, and I'd really like to extend it to other types of cancer, lung cancer, anything I can get data for, so I think the possibility is really endless. I just feel like I really can make a difference now, and that it's really taking off.
Okay, Brittany, amazing.
Thank you so much.
So this project is a combination of computer science and life science, in fact, clinical life science, very, very different endeavors, and really actually shows a sophistication in terms of interdisciplinary work that really people generally don't develop until they've been at this science thing for a while.
Well, thank you so much.
And so what I think the audience would be interested in hearing about is, so how did this start? Did it start with you being interested in computer science, or did it start from the life science? So walk us through what kind of got you going in this direction.
So I've always been a naturally very curious person, and I found science and I found all these answers to my questions. And in seventh grade, I took an elective course on futuristic thinking. And I came across the concept of artificial intelligence because I was researching technologies of the future. I was enthralled. And I very naively decided that that was what I was going to do. I never coded anything before. So I went home, I bought a coding book, and I did learn artificial intelligence. And I created a program that played soccer because I'm an avid soccer player. And then in 10th grade, my cousin was diagnosed with breast cancer. Well, when I was in 10th grade. And so I really was able to combine my developed passion for computer science with my newly found passion for breast cancer and create something that could save lives.
So did you... I'm speechless, really. Did you really think that you could do something here that was going to work and that really would make a difference?
So fine needle aspirates are the least invasive form of biopsy. Using them, they're less costly, they're more timely, and they lead to earlier detection. So I knew that I wanted to do something that could get these back into use, because right now they're so inconclusive that a lot of doctors couldn't use them. And I had this idea to combine the concept of artificial intelligence. But I started this as a 10th grader, so I had no idea whether that'd be something I'd be able to be presenting at the Google Science Fair now, or whether that'd be something that I would take years of college to develop. And I did fail twice before I got a successful project, but that's what's great about science, is you learn just as much from those flopped experiences as you do from your successful ones.
So tell us what's next.
Right, so moving forward, the Google Science Fair has really given me this amazing platform that I can use to share my research with the rest of the world. So I'm working with Lankanau as a hospital up in Philadelphia, and they're giving me more samples. Because right now, the project is 99.1% sensitive to malignancy, which is huge. But I ran 7.6 million trials, and as I get more data, it'll get better. So that's immediately on the horizon. I'm also working on extending it to other types of cancer and other types of diagnostics. And then I want to work on the image processing side of things, too. So.
Great. Never underestimate a young person. All right. Okay. Well, on behalf of all of us, stay inspired. Keep going for it. Amazing that at this level that we have science projects that are actually making a difference in terms of the results that are coming out at this level. So congratulations.
Thank you.